All right, I'm excited to share this video because over the last 6-8 months, I've been nerding out about a new CRM and specifically a new program that helps with sequences. And these are sales sequences. So think of it as if you're a HubSpot power user, like I've been for the last decade, we train customers and clients also how they can leverage sales sequences. And as I was digging into Apollo, I was finding out some of the bells and whistles are much more fruitful when it comes to reaching out to your prospects to educate them about your solution. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through at a high level, 2 or 3 ways that you can really stand out when it comes to sales sequences versus HubSpot sales sequences. So let me put the screen up here. As you can see, this is a little bit similar to HubSpot sequences in the fact that you're setting up steps, you're setting up emails. This is the game changer right here. So if you look at it, day one, we've got an email that goes out. What I found the big difference between HubSpot and Apollo is the fact that you can set up multiple touch points beyond the email. HubSpot is very good when it comes to setting up these sequences specifically for emails. But when you're trying to stand out, not only in the inbox, but also on social platforms like LinkedIn or also doing phone calls, this is the game changer here. So as an example, this is a 10-step sequence. Your sequence could be up to 15 steps or maybe 5 steps. I think the big thing to keep in mind when you're setting up these sequences is, how long does it typically take for you to transfer the information about your product or your solution into your prospect's brain to understand more about your solution or more about your product, right? So think about that for the number of steps you want to incorporate. As I mentioned, this is a 10-step sequence, specifically around a strategy for conferences. But email, let's get into this for a second. So email, day one goes out. Cool. Typically, that's exactly what HubSpot sets up. Here's the game changer. Phone call, you can set up a trigger. So if I'm the person on the sales team or the biz dev team, or even maybe in someone that's doing lead gen for your company, this is where you can make it automated. So you get that email that goes out day one. Day one, as soon as that email goes out, you can set up a phone call. That's a trigger. That's going to automatically send a trigger for you onto your task to do a phone call. Then you can do a LinkedIn profile. You can set it up to do view the profile, comment on a post, make a connection, which is huge. So these are all task orientated. And again, it's built into the sequence. So the big difference is here with HubSpot, you're just setting it up via email. That's it. We all know that everybody's inbox is jammed, right? So how do you stand out on other platforms like a phone call or on LinkedIn? This is the way to do it. It's a game changer. So, and the cool thing about this too is you can also go in here and if you have call scripts, you can put that in here as well for the phone call. If you have a LinkedIn, if you want to interact with the post, right, you can put that, not necessarily that interaction with the post, but again, it's just a trigger to say, hey, you need to follow them. You need to comment on their post. You need to make some sort of outreach on LinkedIn. And again, you can add steps. It just depends on what your sequence is, what your strategy is, but that's really the game changer. So if you break it down real quick here, HubSpot versus Apollo. Apollo is definitely, when it comes to the functionality of multiple touch points, it's the gold star, right? It's the elite, where if you're looking at HubSpot, it's great if you're just looking for email sequences through the inbox. That's the big difference between both of those. So as you plan out your sequences for 2023 and beyond, hopefully this information has been helpful. Look forward to talking to you soon. Bye for now.